Look at the pendulum as it swings back and forth. Visualize your desires, your most hidden desire.
Okay, don't worry, we're not gonna talk about woo-woo paranormal stuff. I'm still Alvaro, this is still the Omni Calculator channel, and today we're gonna use science as an excuse to talk about distraction. No, really, we are going to destroy a house. It's actually this aesthetically challenged house, but should still make for some sweet slow motion. So where do we start? Pendulums, of course. They are the most efficient and useful tool for demolition. Why a pendulum? Well, a pendulum is what physicists see when the rest of the people just see a wrecking ball. If we want to understand why pendulums are so efficient and so useful, we need to understand destruction at a physical level. For that, we need to understand that to get destruction, we need power. Actually, I meant power in a physical sense. So that means to put more energy into the system in less amount of time. You see, to get more power, we either put more energy into the system or we decrease the amount of time that it takes to apply that energy. So why not both? Well, that's exactly what we want to do, but it's not easy. Crushing is an inherently inefficient process. All the energy gets converted into heat and destruction in general. To minimize the time of contact, we can either use rigid objects like ceramic and metal, or we can use faster speeds. Think about a gentle push versus a punch, for example. To increase the energy without any dangerous explosions, we can use a heavier pendulum or we can increase the speed at which it moves. Think about bumping into a doorframe versus getting hit by a speeding car. Did you notice the common denominator? Speed can help us put more energy into the system while applying that energy in less time. Unfortunately, speed comes with friction, so you have to use that kinetic energy quickly or it will be lost. That's kind of inconvenient. Isn't there a safe way to store the energy until we can use it? Something like a battery, but without any losses. Actually, there is. It's gravitational potential energy. Just like a hydroelectric power plant stores its energy in the water up high and then converts it into kinetic energy when the water falls down into the turbines. And for this type of energy, only two factors matter: weight and height. So the heavier the object we have and the higher we can keep it, the more energy we can store. Typically, you would want to smash things horizontally instead of vertically so that you can better control the debris flying away. And that's exactly what our pendulum excels at. It converts gravitational potential energy into horizontal kinetic energy. We could even lift incredibly heavy objects if we use some pulleys and get some very low effort smashing. Oh my god, okay. But for now, let's focus on the pendulum and its main defining feature, the period. Is what I would say if I wanted to give you information you don't actually need. In fact, we just need to look at the kinetic and the potential energies. I can explain you why using the formulas and all the equations, but I'd rather keep it slightly more interactive with an online calculator just like this one. Full disclaimer, at Omni Calculators, we make online calculators. I know, shocker. You can use any calculator that you want, but I just prefer Omni Calculators because they give you the result immediately without having to press any button. And also because I know the people there, they are very nice people. And you can see here that if I change the mass or the initial height, then the maximum speed changes, but the period doesn't. That's because the period only depends on the force of gravity and on the length of the pendulum. If you don't believe me, don't worry, you can just follow the link in the video description and take a look at the equation. Otherwise, you can actually build a pendulum in your house and check for yourself that everything holds true. If you have a small space, like I do, you'd want to go for a shorter length. But a longer pendulum means a higher maximum speed available, so we need to find a balance. So given the constraints of my room, in the end I ended up settling for this pendulum, which is about half a meter long, and it weighs about half a kilogram, which means that when I drop it from the highest point possible, it would smash the house with an energy upon impact of about 2.5 joules. This might not seem like much, and it is not, because you probably burn more calories while sleeping in less than a minute, but given that this ball is going to be moving very fast, about 11 kilometers per hour at the bottom, the time of collision is going to be very short, and therefore I'm pretty confident we're going to be able to smash this house into pieces and just completely wreck it. So, are you ready to smash? Let's go! Let's put it at maximum height and go! And since we can never have too much of a good thing, I'm just gonna do it again until we get rid of this. Go! That was fun, wasn't it? We finally got rid of that. We have learned how pendulums work, and we have tested it empirically by smashing to pieces that hideous house. Now is the time to put all that smashing knowledge to work and smash the like button if you enjoyed the physics of it or just the destruction part. I'm sure I will be doing more stuff with pendulums and maybe seeing if we can trust them with our lives or not. So hit the subscribe button and I will see you in the next video. Until then, bye!
The aftermath. So much destruction.